Hello and welcome to another video. Today we have something way different on our bench. We have a mini PC from PELADN, I think it's called. This was sent in by a viewer. Yeah, this is a mini PC. Then we have the model MI4, I think. No, WI4, 12 volts, 3 amps. 512 gig model with 16 gigs of RAM as far as it seems. And this is supposed to not turn on. So we can, this uses a barrel jack, a DC barrel jack, has HDMI, two HDMIs, that's interesting, one Ethernet port, two USB here, more USB here, and a combined headphone jack. Power button, I didn't get provided the power supply for this, but we will just need to inject 12 volts into the DC jack in order to make this work. So let's get this thing apart. Because it's obviously, it is not working. And I want to have a good look at the electronics first before I will inject voltage into there or like supply voltage to the main power rail. So let's get the four screws out of the back in order to get the bottom lifted. And there's the bottom removed. And this mini PCs often work like a laptop and less like an ATX motherboard. You can see SODIMM sockets definitely here. We have a BIOS battery right in the middle. We have an M.2 socket. I see something probably resembling a Wi-Fi card or a Bluetooth card, something like that. Let's get some more screws out of here in order to take the board completely out of its casing. So now we got the board out of its casing, and now we got the most interesting part on this side. We have power button, we have DC barrel jack input, we got the actual main compute unit right here. And yeah, it will be way easier for now to go from here, but I will probably have to take the cooler off in order to have a good look here. I think there's just two screws holding it in. And after removing the fan and getting the adhesive off of here, we should now, with these four screws, should be able to take off the actual heatsink and reveal all of the beauty of this board. And there we got the actual heatsink out now, and the fan can be left attached, and now we can actually see the board with everything. So now we can see actually the CPU and the PCH integrated into one unit. And the big question now is what is wrong with this board? It doesn't turn on, I got told. And yeah, It looks very, very similar to a mainboard, if you have looked at that, or like a laptop, because you have an ITE chip right there. This is the SIO that we have. Then we can see a bunch of coils. This is probably the main power rail for the CPU. Then there's two more here, maybe for the memory something. Then I can see a BIOS chip right there. There's more auxiliary power supplies right here. And yeah, on the backside there's not too much. Like, there's the Wi-Fi IC, this is for Ethernet. Just some small things here. I don't think that this was ever taken out of its casing, so I wouldn't think there would be any physical damage. So I think we will actually have something electrical. So there's two ways we could start this now. Is either by instantly checking some of these these inductors in order to check for resistance, or we go ahead and put 12 volts into here and see for that. But I think we should go the safe route here and just check for some resistances on these coils. I have no idea what to expect on any of them, because I've never fixed any of these before. But I generally just want to see if we can find something that is like, that seems abnormal. So let's check that coil right there at the top. Okay, let's go in a higher range, 20k ohm range. There we get 500 ohms. Then another coil right next to it. This has very low ohms. Okay, this doesn't seem right. This might be actually our problem right here then. Yeah, this is straight up 0 ohms on this coil. That is probably our problem. We will have to take a good look at that later. But first, let's check some more resistances. This is the CPU. No, this has a little bit high resistance for the CPU. But it looks like it would be that. But 600 ohms, okay. This looks more like it could be the CPU. Right here. But this is also low resistance on these coils here. Or not only on this one then. Yeah, this coil has low resistance. This coil has high resistance. Or higher resistance. That is very interesting. So we have two coils with very low resistance. I got to be honest, I wouldn't want to plug power into this now. Because there seems to be too much shorted here. Like, that is very suspicious, that what we have here so far. This is, I think, the main power rail problem right here. There are three diodes. Let's not do the overview. Let's go under the microscope and investigate further and better. So this is the one that has low resistance on it, this coil. And the big question is, what kind of regulator will this be? This one doesn't have low resistance. This one doesn't have low resistance, and this looks like it would be CPU phase, just like this one up here. So they are not shorted, but this one is showing a short. And then in addition to that one, we have, this is the BIOS chip I was talking about, and this one also shows a short circuit. And this one is, I think, interesting. This is probably from this regulator right here. Yeah, exactly. So we have this step-down converter connecting to here. This is its output right there, you can see. And probably this is being its input, most likely. Maybe this one. So its output is probably shorted. Or this one is an input, because this has also big capacitors. This is probably the input, and this is the output, and this seems shorted. This one is not shorted. This one has high resistance, and is probably coming from this one. So it's very unlikely to have actually two things shorted. This would be very interesting, but we will probably have to investigate this with a thermal camera. Like, we will get like 1 volt to inject into here. And then also 1 volt to inject into this coil right here. And then check what gets hot. Because I don't think that it will, that both of these feed the same thing that is shorted. But yeah, we will have to find that out. Because obviously I don't have schematics for any of these. The visual inspection so far just shows that it's dirty. I couldn't see anything that is obviously blown up. Like, no capacitor that looks blown up, no MOSFET that burned through or anything like that. Also, the regulators itself look fine. Best case scenario would be if this is a short capacitor somewhere. But it's weird that we have two shorted coils. But yeah, so far with visual inspection, there's nothing really to see here. Because also this backside doesn't really have anything that is... that resembles another power supply. Most of this seems to be logic only on the backside. And there's something even not configured here. So yeah, this backside has very few components. Mostly holds the sockets for the DDR and the M.2. Even another port that could be soldered here but isn't. Interesting. And this is where our main power rail hooks up to. So I guess we don't have a short across the main power rail, because the short is actually located across, we don't have a short across a secondary power supply. So then let's go over to the overhead again, and let's try to inject the voltage then. So current setup, we have through USB, I have my ground lead connected, and then I have this PIC tool this picture where 1 volt is connected. Let me update the power supply so you can actually see that. So now we can actually see the, where is it, there, the actual 1 volt, and let's see for its power consumption. So we're going to be attaching to that coil, and let's see, 1.5, 1.7 amps, that is what was heating up so fast. Okay, and let's see then, is there an IC right there that is shorted? It kind of looks like it. Let's have a good look again. Okay, no, it doesn't seem to be that. Something must be getting incredibly hot, because so far I can only see like where I'm injecting the voltage to be getting hot, but there must be something that is getting really hot on the board here. Okay, it might be on the backside of the board, because all I can see, as you can see here, all I can see is the spot where I'm injecting voltage, and it's only the coil getting hot. And if I do it, let's see, if I do it from this side, it should, the coil shouldn't be getting hot anymore. Or is this, the PCH? Or this might be the PCH that is dead. Oh yeah, I think so. Oh man, no, really? Let me solder a wire to them and attach to that, and then we will see. So let's have a good look now again. You can see I have a wire right here and the USB again. Through the USB, I'm just grabbing the ground. And when I attach this wire right now, we will probably see that the PCH is lighting up. So let's get the macro lens onto here. Hover over the PCH. And let's have a good look here. Yeah, exactly there. You could see that corner heating up. Taking that off, and you can see exactly only the corner heating up of the PCH. Now it's very well to see. This is very sad. I'm very interested what the other short is, to be honest, that we had. So let's also inject a voltage there and see if that also heats up the PCH then. So still 1 volt of voltage. Let's inject that into here. And there we have very similar, yeah, and it's another place at the PCH, as you can see right here. So the PCH is completely shorted. That explains why we have two shorts here. We have through two different voltage rails, probably like a 3.3 volt rail and a 1 volt rail, we are shorted into the PCH. And this time it's a different corner that is the PCH actually. Oh, this is very sad. So you can see very well, injecting into this one, we get a short at the upper part, and injecting into the other one, we see a short at the top right. So this PCH has really gotten it. Like, don't know how that happened, but it really blew through at two spots. That is very sad. There's certainly nothing we can do. Let's see under the microscope for this, if we can actually see, like, a, if there's something, like, ripped on here, or if we have any fracturing. So let me clean up the thermal paste a little bit more and see if we can visually see something that happened to this PCH. So having IPA on here, there's really nothing to see. Sometimes you can locate cracks like that, putting some IPA into them, and then the IPA will flood into the cracks and can actually see something. But yeah, the PCH is somewhere here shorted in the top right corner and somewhere in the upper corner right here. But there's really nothing to see, sadly. It's just completely dead. And this being a combo unit of CPU and PCH, there's nothing even you can do to rescue this or use part of it, because it's just dead. Yeah, and when trying to clean any of this up, let's see, can we see any kind of cracks? But it doesn't really seem like it. I'm trying to kind of like polish this in order to find out if there's anything. Let's take a dry cloth, polish this crystal a little bit. But it looks immaculate. Like, at the spots where we saw short circuits, there's absolutely nothing. This crystal, this silicon crystal, looks absolutely clean. So no amount of visual inspection would have led you to this one being damaged. As you can see, by using a clean cloth, polishing it a little bit, there is nothing. Like, there's a single scratch right there at the corner right there, but that has nothing to do with where we had our short circuits. And yeah, this crystal looks immaculate otherwise, but is sadly shorted through two different power rails. So this basically already concludes the repair, very sadly. I wished I could have helped this viewer that sent this over, but this is sadly just a dead case where nothing can be done here. This is one of the big reasons why I avoid Intel boards so much, because like so many dead Intel boards just have a shorted PCH, and then the video turns out to be a nothing burger at all, because there's very little to learn here. Like, if you see two different power rails shorted like that, you can assume it's going to be the PCH, and that is all that you can take out. Or maybe this is one way of you knowing how to confirm if you have a dead PCH. Like, if you have located heat spots like we have here, with the corner, the top right corner and top middle having heat signature, that's just a dead PCH, sadly. I will get this thing back together, but this sadly only is for spares now. Only the parts can be taken off here. Maybe someone will have a use for the BIOS that is on here or something like that. But yeah, sadly nowhere where we can go for this repair. But I hope you still enjoyed it. All of my tools, as always, are linked in the video description. This was Mainboard Medic. Thank you very much and goodbye.